Ongoing soil degeneration will lead us to the next ice age, collapse, and extinction. The period around the Younger Dryas event, as well as the biblical Noah's Ark narrative, are in fact stark warnings of the fact that our systematical lack of sustainability and the consequential progression of soil degeneration could and probably already is, or relatively soon will become humans' major threat. The biblical Noah's Ark narrative is an extension of the Younger Dryas, as well as all former much more disastrous 100,000 years long ice ages. Some of us are distracted from this cruel reality by mere and often completely non-scientific but compelling narratives. YDIH or Younger Dryas Impact Hypothesis. Some are distracted by means of the meteorite impact hypothesis or the cosmic impact hypothesis. While others are distracted by the biblical Noah's Ark narrative, while still others are distracted by the narrative that carbon dioxide causes warming and is our only, or by far our worst threat. Not that carbon dioxide and warming are not things that should be carefully observed, they certainly should, simply because certain carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is a realistic marker of soil degeneration, and we claim that soil degeneration indeed is a major warming factor, as well as climate challenging factor, this rather independent from carbon dioxide, and already is or soon will become and be recognized as our by far worst and imminent threat. Especially the carbon dioxide that is provenient from soil degeneration, and not provenient from fossil fuels, is an essential marker of soil degeneration, which is a certain threat for food security, and a kind of near-endless emitter of carbon dioxide, and will still be emitting carbon dioxide long after we stopped using fossil fuels, or long after oil reserves have become depleted. NASA and scientists are able to differentiate between carbon dioxide originating from fossil fuels, and carbon dioxide originating from other origins, like from vegetation, etc. The Younger Dryas, as well as the biblical Noah's Ark narrative, distract and possibly kind of hide a major continental scale or even global population turnover event or PTE. The early modern humans culture in Europe and Western Eurasia, as well as the Neanderthals in Europe and Western Eurasia, and also the Denisovan in Eastern Eurasia, Indonesia, and Oceania, were regional introductions of the here meant global population turnover event or PTE, as well as of the later Tars Tepler sites, the Fertile Crescent, etc. The Clovis Culture people, or rather their sudden disappearance or reduction, possibly were part of this migration and population turnover event or PTE, by also migrating from North America to Europe and Western Eurasia. We claim that a wide variety of American groups, possibly including the American Clovis Culture people, all being part of a larger advanced civilization, migrated away from the Americas to other continents, including to Western Europe as well as Western Eurasia. In Europe and Western Eurasia, this wide variety of American groups gave rise to mainly two groups of hunter-gatherers and two groups of farmers before 8,000 years ago, which event seemingly was first detected by geneticist David Reich and others around 2015, this by means of ancient DNA. We show these four massive groups on your screen. You can see the by these ancient Americans followed ocean routes laid out on your screen in the case of YDNA haplogroup R and its subclades, with YDNA haplogroup R and its subclades being the dominant haplogroup in the world today. This subject and chapter is argued and proven in other videos and playlists. Step ancestry improbable, impossible, or plain wrong. We claim this is the case because historians and consensus tend to fragmentize over and over. It is not impossible that they do this to avoid the general public to see the big picture, amongst others because the big picture, just as the ancestral markers, pops up an inconvenient truth. The truth that the ancestral markers showed us all along, and that is that the origin of Europeans and Western Eurasians, independent if they are hunter-gatherers or farmers, is American. You will see in this video and many of our videos that consensus, including historians, leave our geneticists no other choice than to tell us what our geneticists themselves know is improbable, that we all descended out of the Eastern European steppe. How would it be possible that a wide variety of cultures, languages, and DNA would come from the spatial and otherwise very limited Eastern European steppe, with no agriculture, no dairy, no ruminant meat like cow meat, and not even ruminant milk like cow milk? And yet these consequently sparse Eastern European steppe people are assumed to have turned over and also to have populated, and this in a record time, the whole of the immense Eurasia, the Americas, and even significant parts of Africa, to make up the dominant haplogroup in the world. All this is highly questionable and highly improbable, if not laughable. Clear examples are provided in other videos. Depleting resources in the Americas. The depletion of resources, that is the subject of this chapter, could be a factor next to soil degeneration, as well as rising sea levels, that would increase competition and conflicts for space. Depleting resources like copper and other essential resources, or the relative abundance of certain essential or valued resources in Western Eurasia could have been amongst the reasons of the migrations and/or population turnover events. The Younger Dryas, the Old and Older Dryas, as well as all glacials of at least the last 400,000 years, are clear warnings for what could happen if we 8 billion humans continue unaware and unprepared for the threats, including and especially the threat of one more historical collapse, into a very long and destructive ice age, that can vary from over 1,000 years long to over 100,000 years long. That is that soil degeneration, which is associated with rising carbon dioxide levels, leads up to a weakening and unstable AMOC or Atlantic meridional overturning circulation, and a weakening AMOC could and probably will lead up to an over 1,000-year-long ice age equivalent to the Younger Dryas, or a much worse 100,000-long typical glacial or ice age. Human divisions, and some random examples of them. The USA is politically divided in Democrats and Republicans, while much of the rest of the global West is similarly divided or in equivalents. Democrats and their equivalents are worried about warming and other climate challenges, which they assume to be associated with increasing carbon dioxide levels. Republicans or their equivalents do not believe what the Democrats are worried about, and at least some of them even recognize cooling, this at least here and there. Republicans and their equivalents are worried that humans do not thrive as before, and kind of consequently do not thrive sufficiently to sustain their economy, and in a way to sustain more or less 8 billion humans. Both Democrats and Republicans seem to be partially right in almost a twist of irony regarding these destructive divisions, but they are both essentially and dangerously wrong for a number of reasons, including because of the divisions they generate. As long as we humans stay divided, we will not do what is needed, and in fact inflate existing challenges and any eventual perfect storm, or even create new challenges that could inflate or trigger the perfect storm. We seem to be unaware that each 100,000-year-long glacial starts out with a warming that seems to melt ice masses beyond a critical point, at what point the temperature at the poles exceeds 0 degrees, when ice masses melt quicker and lead to the weakening or to instability of the AMOC. We claim that the lack of carbon agroforests, or also deforestation, systematical forest degeneration, as also in the case of selective logging, and obviously the transformation of forests and agricultural lands, will lead to the point the temperature at the poles exceeds 0 degrees, this largely independent of if the temperatures in the rest of the world rise or fall. Massive transformation of forests and agricultural lands is to be expected in and before the year 2050. This is simply so because 90% of our actual agricultural lands globally will have become degenerated and or unproductive by the year 2050, and the pressure for deforestation to create new agricultural land will be large. And it is when the AMOC starts weakening, or becomes unstable, that the humans of that period collapse out of their interglacials, or out of their interglacial equivalents of our Holocene, and into a disastrous glacial or ice age, and this systematically for a period of roughly 100,000 years. So the real threat or danger seems to be the weakening or instability of the AMOC. The weakening or unsustainability of the AMOC seems to happen at the point the temperature at the poles exceeds 0 degrees, when ice masses melt quicker, and lead to the weakening or the instability of the AMOC, and next the collapse out of the ongoing interglacial takes place, and this systematically for a period of roughly 100,000 years. Practices similar to ancient Amazon Amerindians, but adapted to modern life, for quality of life and existence. This is about our claim that in order to solve our challenges and to achieve quality of life and existence, we need to know our origin and its practices, which include sustainable carbon agroforest practices, as for example in the ancient Americas and the Amazon forest. We claim, and there is evidence, that the practices of the Amazon Amerindians, which include sustainable carbon agroforest practices, are the main reasons for their survival, exceptional health, thriving and impressive expansions. That is because our existence depends on us acquiring again the lifestyle our ancestors practiced, which we occasionally also call the Horn of Abundance, and which made them thrive and expand, and rendered them stable DNA. Obviously, the lifestyle our ancestors practiced, and which made them thrive, and rendered them stable DNA, should be adapted to modern life. Global plan for existence, that also includes necessary existing centers and models. All our videos and channels are in function of and promoting a global plan for existence, that also includes necessary existing centers and models. There is increasing evidence that we modern humans existed for over 1 million years. We also have arguments and evidence that we humans historically and systematically destroyed our soils, and consequently our climate, as well as the stability of our DNA. These cyclical collapses, of roughly each 100,000 years, which in fact are kinds of dropping or crashing out of interglacials, as well as the anomalies from a glacial to an interglacial period, can be easily and clearly seen in the global temperature change, as well as sea level change, for example over the last 400,000 years, in the climate science investigations, or in the CSI done by NASA. From our civilizations and complex economy standpoint, at least from the civilizations and economies outside the tropics' standpoint, a collapse out of our today's interglacial, which we call Holocene, would mean the total collapse of civilizations and economies outside the tropics, which is roughly the developed world or the global West. This and other videos on this channel have been translated and or dubbed into more than 5 languages, including the official languages of the 9 Amazonian countries, this to support this initiative and plan to unite the 8 billion inhabitants of the planet around this action plan for carbon agroforestry, generating important jobs, new business opportunities, and boosting the economy. If you'd also like to support this initiative, subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, ask a question, or give a like to this video.